Ben Bernanke assured everybody that the Fed was not monetizing the debt, that we would never do that. This is the United States. We're not a banana republic. We don't monetize debt. He said that we are not permanently buying this debt. This is just a temporary situation. As soon as the emergency is over, the Fed is going to sell all of these bonds that it bought during the emergency. Now, I called out Bernanke real time and said, that's not true. That's never going to happen. Either Bernanke is lying or he's incompetent. The Fed is monetizing the debt. They're never going to sell these bonds. They're going to live on the balance sheet in perpetuity. Once you go down this rabbit hole, there's no turning back, that the Fed was going to be permanently financing U.S. government debt. Once again, the Fed was wrong, and I was right. Now, when they began to taper, right, after QE3, when they said, okay, we're done, we're going to normalize interest rates and shrink the balance sheet, I said that's impossible. Even if the Fed tries to normalize rates, it will fail. If it begins to shrink its balance sheet, it will never complete the process. It will immediately have to go back to QE. I alone was predicting QE4. In fact, I predicted QE infinity. The Fed said, no, we're going to normalize rates. We're going to shrink the balance sheet. It's going to be like watching paint dry. Again, everything the Federal Reserve said about their ability to normalize rates and shrink the balance sheet was wrong. I said that they were wrong as they were saying it. They never were able to normalize interest rates. They never came close to returning the balance sheet to pre-crisis levels. In the fourth quarter of 2018, the Fed abandoned the rate hikes at about 2.5%, not even close to normal. They called off quantitative tightening. By 2019, the Fed was back to rate cuts. When they cut rates in 2019, what did the Fed say? This is a mid-course correction. Don't worry. We'll be raising rates again shortly. What did I say? I said, it's not a mid-course correction. This is the beginning. We're going back to zero. And that's exactly what happened. When the Fed first started doing QE, when the repo market blew up, they denied it was QE. I said, it's exactly QE. The Fed is lying. They're no longer lying. They've dropped the pretense. They're doing QE. It's QE infinity. Not only are interest rates at zero, but the Fed is now saying that they're going to remain there indefinitely. The Fed is now admitting to what I said was going to happen from the beginning, that it is now a permanent fixture in the bond market, that the government is now so hopelessly in debt. There are now so many bonds out there that there's no way the private sector can finance this. Therefore, the Fed is the only way to keep the bond market from imploding, to keep the U.S. government from going bankrupt. And so we are now the banana republic that Ben Bernanke assured us we would never become. But my point of going through this long list of Fed failures is to point out something that should be obvious. The Federal Reserve has never been right. Everything they have said about the efficacy of their policies, what their policies would create, and their ability to reverse them or unwind them has been wrong. And it's amazing how consistently wrong they've been. In fact, it's hard to believe that it's just the result of incompetence. Because if the Fed was incompetent, maybe just out of sheer chance, they would have got something right. The fact that they've never got anything right shows you that maybe there's more to it than just being incompetent. Maybe they are lying. Maybe they're just giving disinformation because their main goal is simply to kick the can down the road. That's all they care about. They don't care about what the damage they're doing to the economy. They just want to make sure that the consequences from that damage happen later rather than sooner, even if by delaying the day of reckoning, they make it much worse.